We spend a majority of our lives waiting on somebody to love us, somebody who we expect to have something within them that is going to fulfill us. When in truth, a majority of those we wait upon to love us do not even understand what it is to love themselves. And as we waste that time and energy waiting on love, we forget to cultivate the love within ourselves for ourselves. And I'm not saying this from a soapbox. I'm not saying this in a preachy way. I'm speaking from experience. I've come to a point where I've finally seen that I spend a majority of my life wanting to be liked. I spend a majority of my life wanting to be accepted. And most times it was subconscious. If we were in conversation, I would tell you that I didn't care what people thought of me. But in truth, I would do things in order to compromise who I truly was, in order for you to accept me. And the only reason I would do that is because I did not fully, truly, and authentically appreciate myself. I spent so much of my time, so much of my effort, so much of my energy, so much of my life force trying to get you to approve of me because I did not approve of me. And what I've come to realize after long reflection and, you know, enough meditation for both of us is this: there can be no love in our lives if there is no love within us first. You've heard this, it's been Pinterested, it's been Instagrammed to death, but the truth that lays in this statement is one that is undervalued and undermined and most times belittled, right? It just becomes this cliche, the status quo thing to say. But it is true that if we do not seek the cultivation, and I do mean cultivation, because it's something we have to develop within ourselves, it's something that we have to work on within ourselves, because so many of us have had it worked out of us. We have to cultivate love within ourselves for ourselves completely. And the most powerful statement for myself, and hopefully it can be for you as well, is: are you willing to love yourself as you would love your own infant child, right? And for some of us, are you willing to love yourself as much as you love your pet, right? With an unconditional type of love, with the type of love that is continuous, regardless of circumstance, a type of love that's not earned, a type of love that's not given because of, the type of love that is there just because. And as I take that statement and as I ponder on it, I think to myself, I got a whole lot of work to do.